100 relays about to
back at the Olympic pool and ready now for the start of an event which should be one of the most exciting in this entire competition. And there you see another of the numerous false starts which have plagued the men's competition, but that gives us a chance to set this up. Back again at the pool and ready once again for the second try at a start in the 4x100 meter freestyle relay for men. The Olympic record was set in qualifying by the Australians. They'll be swimming in lane 4. The world record is held by the United States. The American team will be anchored by 100-meter gold medalist Rowdy Gaines. The Australian team will be anchored by the silver medalist Mark Stockwell. And the West Germans are in lane 7. If they stay in the hunt, their anchor is Mikhail Gross. I don't have to tell you what happened in the 4x200-meter freestyle relay earlier in the competition when Gross and Bruce Hayes dueled to the finish with Hayes touching him out. Very quickly, from the top of your screen to the bottom, Italy in lane 1, France in lane 2, Sweden in lane 3. They could be in the hunt. Australia in 4, the USA in 5. Great Britain in 6th, West Germany in 7th. They qualified without Gross, and in lane 8, Canada. And as they come back after 50 meters, it is the team in lane 6, Great Britain, with David Lowe swimming the leadoff leg, which has the lead.
Expect the lead to change quite often here. It's very interesting to see the strategy of all the teams. In the team from Australia, the United States, and West Germany, they placed their fastest man in the last position. But going in the second position right now will be for Australia, their fourth fastest swimmer. For the United States, Michael Heath will be the second fastest swimmer we have. And for West Germany, Schmidt, which is their third fastest.
Chris Kavanaugh swam the opening leg for the United States in 50.83 and gave the Americans the lead. Now the Australians have taken the lead back away as Neil Brooks, who swam a very fast leg in qualifying this morning, takes over for them. For the United States, Mike Heath is in the pool. He has not been swimming at his best in this meet, but he got a slow start in the 100 meters the other night and would love to get some revenge here.
I think we're going to see some of these swimmers swimming on the side of the lanes, either to stay away from their competitors or try to move up towards their competitors by dragging off of them. It can be used to an advantage or a disadvantage if you swim right next to and you're out in the lead from being dragged on.
The Australians and the Americans a body length in front and almost dead even as they come down to touch off to the third men for each team. For the Americans, 18-year-old Matt Biondi from Moraga, California, a former water polo player who's emerged from nowhere to become one of the best freestyle sprinters in the world. For the Australians, Michael Delaney with the yellow bathing cap on, and the Australians have a lead. It looks as though it's going to be a battle between Stockwell and Rowdy Gaines because West Germany has dropped well back in lane 7.
Biondi could use swimming on the lane lines right out to his advantage to ride a drag off of Delaney from Australia. And you can see the two men have actually started to move towards each other. Sometimes moving back and forth takes up extra distance, and by swimming the extra distance, you're wasting time. But sometimes it can work to your advantage. It's going to be a close race, Jim.
Matt Biondi is catching Delaney. It looks as though Biondi is going to give Rowdy Gaines a little bit of the lead. Over in lane 7, Mikhail Gross is up for West Germany, but it looks like this time they're too far back. Gaines got a heck of a start, but now Mark Stockwell has moved right up next to him. Stockwell was very angry about the start of the 100 meters, thought that he would have beaten Gaines with a fair start. Now he gets his chance for revenge.
If he's going to do it, he's going to have to swim like he's never swum before in the first 50 meters, and he's moved up on Gaines. Gaines may be just plotting, waiting for him, trying to gain some strength and energy for the last 50 meters. It's going to come down to the wire. Now Gaines breathes on his right side. He cannot see Stockwell, not unless he changes breathing pattern.
Rowdy is swimming very well, though, Mark. He's starting to pull away now. This would be the second gold medal for Rowdy Gaines. He would have been favored to win 4 or 5 in Moscow, and it absolutely turned his heart upside down to be able to win one the other night in the 100-meter free final. He's going to do it again. Rowdy Gaines will touch the wall. 3:19.03, a brand new world record. The Australians with Stockwell came in second. Mikhail Gross swam a heck of an anchor leg to get Germany into fourth, but the bronze medal will belong to Sweden, which also got a good anchor leg from Barry Johansson. But another gutty performance for Rowdy Gaines of the United States, 25 years old and having an Olympics that he'll never forget.
Let's give credit to Coach Don Gamble. He placed his men in the proper order. He had his fastest swimmer, Rowdy Gaines, going last. Kavanaugh, which was the third, was the first leadoff. Heath, which was the second fastest, went second, and Biondi the fourth. And they were able to actually hold on to a substantial margin, enough to give Gaines the opportunity to bring it in.
Mark, Rowdy swam his 100 meters in 48.93. To put that in perspective, the world record in the 100 meters is 49.36. Here's a super slow-mo of Gaines' turn on the last turn. Stockwell next to him.
Gaines, the one that's on the left-hand side of the screen, turns first. You can see him flipping over. Now, Stockwell had actually moved up on him. He had gained about a quarter of a body length here. Now, it's important that Gaines holds his breath through this turn. He takes a stroke here. There's a tremendous wave right there. However, he took a breath. That's okay. He went above the wave. Normally, if he was thinking about it in a 100 individual event, he probably wouldn't have taken that breath, but it was good enough for the win.
And a world record for Chris Kavanaugh, Mike Heath, Matt Biondi, and Rowdy Gaines as the United States has won the 4x100-meter freestyle relay, continuing to dominate the relays here. And we'll be back with more of our Olympic coverage right after this. On the strength of a memorable anchor leg by Rowdy Gaines, the American 4x100-meter freestyle relay team has broken a world record and won a gold medal. All four of them, Kavanaugh, Heath, Biondi, and Gaines, standing by downstairs with Diana.
Yes, Jim, they're not just the Olympic champions, they're the new world record holders, and they are happy. Chris Kavanaugh, you were the leadoff leg. Why did they use you first?
I really can't explain that. I don't know. I have a really good start, and they wanted to try and get me going off early and see what the rest of the guys, you know, kind of get maybe a little bit of lead and see what we could do from there.
I think the coaches have seen you swim NC2A competition, and they know how tough you are. Mike Heath, just another medal for you.
Sweet. That's all I can say.
That's all you need to say. Matt Biondi, you were third in there trying to get Rowdy a lead, and you did it. You came on that second 50. Congratulations. What were you thinking there? Got to do it? Got to give him a lead?
Well, I knew Rowdy. He's the fastest freestyler in this meet. I knew if I could get him a lead, we were going to win the gold. And he came through for us.
Rowdy, talk about finishing a career the right way. We're talking about gold, gold, gold. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot. I really can't take any credit. I mean, these guys did it for me. They got me a lead, and that's all I needed. So the rest came easy.
We got one more gold in you in a few days?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Okay, team, congratulations.
Thank you.
Gaines, of course, will swim again in the medley relay. And now, once again, as we look at the results, let's get back to Jack Whitaker in gymnastics.
Yes, Jack, we're about to hear the American national anthem yet again. The Americans piling up the gold medals in these Olympic Games of Los Angeles. Earlier, we heard O Canada for the Canadian winner. Picture of the young Americans who set a new world record in the relay race. That is the seventh world record in the men's competition out there. Fantastic performance. So from the live picture there, back live again to you, Jackson.